Hello, and welcome to another X-Plane 10 video. Today we're going to do a little something different. I bought a new plugin. I bought the deluxe version of the JarDesign X-Life plugin. I know it's no replacement for VATSIM or flying online with you know, human controllers and stuff like that, but I thought it might be kind of fun to play around with. So I got it. I'm not flown with it at all yet. We're at an airport that I have the files for. We're flying to an airport I have the files for, so we're going to give it a try and see how it goes. We're going to play with its ATC and all that business on this flight. This will be American 413 service from Atlanta Hartsfield-Jackson over to Phoenix Sky Harbor. I believe it's going to take us about almost 4 hours to do. Probably not quite that, we'll see. And we'll get to try out the X-Life plugin. So it should be fun. We'll go ahead and get going. I've already imported a route, got the IRS's aligning, and programmed pretty much everything except the performance page for takeoff and the departure procedure, because we don't have our departure from ATC yet, from X-Life. So we'll go ahead and hop in the flight deck and hit up ATC and see what we get. We do this by going up to the ATC panel.
R123, contact Hartsfield, Jackson delivery.
Whatever.
R123.
Oh my goodness.
Wrong ATIS information. JAR 123. Hartsfield. Jackson delivery.
Oh my gosh, it actually cares what I have QNH currently set to.
JAR 123. Hartsfield. Jackson delivery. Near to Phoenix Sky Harbor Island. Runway 08 left. Initial altitude 20,000 feet. Walk by 333.
Okay, so 5333 is our squawk code. We are cleared up to 20,000 feet. And they didn't give us a SID. But we will be departing off of runway 8 left. So, flight plan, departure, 8 left. Yeah, NASA 1 with the yaw transition. Alright. So there we go. The performance page, transition altitude is 18,000 feet. We are 1/0.3. And our flux temperature, according to PFPX, is going to be 58 degrees. And there are our V-speeds. Go ahead and get the APU started. Nav lights can come on. Fuel pumps can come on. Make sure we are indeed aligned, and we are. That's good to go. QNH is good. The map is good. MCP altitude is good. Everything's good. We can lose external power. and we can lose all of the ground services. Get all the doors closed.
Park brake off. Park brake on.
Make sure I got rid of all the ground handling vehicles. We have a parking brake method. It's really kind of nice how that window doesn't actually fit everything. That's good. There's that. Oh no. Well, I cleared it. Now I don't know how to get it back. Well, we'll deal with that later.
Starting engine two.
I installed version 2 of the sound pack from Blue Sky for this aircraft, and I think I might be in love. That's one of the X-Life planes, you can tell, because it would never ever fly here in real life. There's another one. I don't think we're flying 727s these days. Wait for tail right, nose left. And we'll start number
Starting
one.
Starting engine one. Up to Foxtrot.
to hotel.
Park brake off.
Ignition to normal. And we'll taxi. I don't know if there's a way yet to control what airlines show up at what airports, but like, there's an Aer Lingus, for instance, a tiny Aer Lingus aircraft. At Atlanta. That's not how it works in real life. Just so we're clear. And then this guy is texting into me. We'll go over here. kind of stalled the airplane.
Terrain.
Clear of conflict. Speed check. Flaps zero.
Anyways, that was us off out of Atlanta. Alright, let's go ahead and program the approach and the approach phase, since we have no more waypoints after zoom. We will take ILS 8 into Phoenix, that arrival Novia with a gallop transition. Top of descent, and yeah, so, oh, I should really think about the approach phase as well, or as I'm going to do that, I will
autopilot
hit my joystick and knock it out of autopilot. That's always good to do. So, performance, next page, next page. QNH, we should be in inches of mercury. Why are we not? Because I didn't change it in Atlanta. 30.04. Temperature is 33 degrees. Wind is 80 at 6. Transition altitude is 18,000 feet. And yeah, we'll take full config. Alright, so that's us programmed. We'll descend in a while. I may have to adjust that approach phase on the descent, but other than that, we're good to go, and we'll see you when we're on final. Okay, so I just told XLive ATC that I was ready to descend, and they said when ready to descend to flight level 12, which doesn't exist in the US, so we'll descend at 12,000 feet and expect the Arlen 3 arrival for 7 right. So we'll take 7 rights ILS via Arlen 3. Via, and I'm just going to go with no transition. In which case, we should have already started our descent. So we'll do that now. There we go. Down we go. About to turn final into Phoenix Sky Harbor. Everything's looking good. We're just decelerating now.
Drag, sir. Speed check. Flaps 1.
they give us a tower handoff. We'll go flap 2.
Speed check for flaps 2.
There's our landing clearance.
Radio altimeter alive.
Take flap 3.
Speed check, flaps 3. Speed check, flaps full. Spoilers armed.
Spoilers are armed. Signs are... I turned no smoking off when I thought I turned seatbelts on. That's good. Alright. We'll go ahead and lose the automatics. Let me just draw this route and be fast. Okay, well, first off, in the U.S., you don't set your transponder to standby. Let's just get that straight.
Flaps zero. Spoilers arm. Spoilers disarm.
Get the spoilers in and... I'm going to drive through this guy who's waiting. Oh, looky there. That's amazing. That guy crosses right in front of that dude. That's impressive. Also, why is that guy landing that direction and we landed the other direction? Let's say that we have some issues. Judging by how his ATC has been so far, there will be someone there. We'll
Park brake on.
Parking brake, and we will lose the engines. We'll lose the beacon light. We will take GPU, chocks, catering, stairway one. Nope, we won't take fuel. Cones and loaders. We'll switch to external power and we will lose the APU. We can lose that seatbelt light. Alright, there you go. This has been American 413, service from Atlanta to Phoenix, with the XLive plugin. Trying that out, the deluxe version. Definitely mixed, definitely mixed. It's nice to have traffic, particularly when VATSIM is slow or there aren't any controllers on. Its ATC is... Well, it's not great, but it's better than X-Plane Default, I think. So yeah, take that as you will. Thanks so much for watching. Please leave any feedback or suggestions, requests, whatever, in the comments. Please like the video. Please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time.